We read in the book of Isaiah, chapter 30, verse 20 to 22, it is written that though you eat the bread of suffering and the water of affliction, your God will not simply throw you away. He will talk to you from within. This is the way. Walk in it. Yes, God will continue to. When you move with Him, problems will move with you. But God will talk and counsel you, lead you. But when you move away from the presence of God, when you move away from the holiness, when you defile yourself, when you allow the enemy to defile you, what will happen? The counsel of the Lord will be heard no more. You can't hear the voice of God. The book of Isaiah, chapter 48, verse 17. Thus says the Lord your Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel, I am the Lord your God, who teaches you the way of prophet. I will lead you by the way you should go. It is I who will lead you the way you should go. See, who will teaches you what is good for you. That is called counseling. He will teach you what is good, what is not good. He will teach you what is good for you. And He will lead you the path you are supposed to follow. He will lead you in the path. Because when you are with Him, He will counsel you what you are supposed to do. What is the path you are supposed to follow? That is called counseling. He will constantly talk to you. And the enemy taking you away from the presence of God and defiling your thoughts, defiling your body, He takes you away from God where you don't seek the counsel of God, nor the counsel of the Lord is available for you, because you are gone away. The next thing, what will happen? Verse 17, how often is the lamb of the wicked put out? When you move along with the enemy, you don't seek no more the counsel and the guidance of the Lord, what will happen? The light will go out of your life. The moment the light goes out, the demons will move in. When the light goes out, the demons come in. We have in John chapter 13, verse 30, Judas took the bread and went out of Jesus, and it became dark. The moment you move away from the presence of God, the dark forces enter into you. Enter into you. That's what Jesus said. You have prayed to a servant of God, and the servant of God casted out the evil from you. And you have not run to God's presence. You are not filled with His presence. So the evil spirit watches you. Array. Still it is empty. So if I go alone, again that fellow may say some prayers. So I will take another seven terrible forces. So we all will go inside. Earlier he was only smoking. Now he will be pulled to prostitution. He will be pulled to play here and there. He will go to fight. Oh, this fellow is very soft guy. How he became such a wild fellow? Evil has gone inside. Because you not filled yourself with the presence of God. If you don't burn with the presence of the Holy Spirit, you will burn with the evil. That's what, when you don't move in holiness, the evil will bind you. What will happen? The lamp will be put out. Once the lamp is gone, the light is gone, Jesus said, your eyes are the lamp for your body. If your eyes are bright, Your whole body will be full of light. You throw and nobody is watching. I can watch little blue movie. If I can watch little pornography. I can read certain things. When you give your eyes to the evil will come and defile your whole body. And then you are lost. And Jesus said, if your body is full of darkness, how dark it will be. Means your soul will be thrown into the hellfire. Eye is a very, very important organ. If you don't take care of your eye, meaning not putting all eye ointment. Eye means what you are watching, what you are seeing, where your eyes lead you to. If you are not alert, your whole body, evil can defile you. Your whole life, it can destroy you. These are the ways. In the absence of holiness, in the absence of taking care to move in the presence of God, in the absence of training oneself to do the will of God, what is left out is the evil possession. Why even many servants of God are dying with evil? Because of the lack of holiness. Means they don't make it sure. The goal of my life, whether I eat or drink, I will make it sure that I move in the presence of God and I do what is pleasing to the Lord. Whether I go, whether it is pleasing to the Lord. What I talk, does it please to the Lord? Where I move, where I go with a friendship, whatever may be. Whatever I do, that is called holiness. In the absence of holiness, the enemy will take away. And then it says, verse 17, Job says, how often is the lamb of the wicked is put out, and how often their destruction come upon them. Without anything telling, the destruction come in their lives. Because the enemy knows when to lift you up, to give you money, that to defile your body. He gives you prosperity to destroy yourself along with your family. You have to be very, very careful. Yes, those who don't pray, they lose their direction. They enter into confusion. Yes, they will have no direction and no prosperity, no counsel for them. And how often their destruction comes means there is no more protection. What is the meaning of it? No more protection. Because as long as you are in the Lord, we read in the book of Zechariah, chapter 2, verse 8, I will be with a glory inside you and the fire around you. That is the way the Lord guided his people. When the people of Israel walked in the light which God has put before them, the clouds were above, the light was around. God gave them water from the rock. And then the enemy came in the form of drinks. The enemy showed so many palm trees. And the Canaanite woman tracked the men. And so many Israelites who are walking in the light, when they saw, they preferred that darkness more than this light. So that's what Jesus said. He came as a light, but people desired darkness than the light. He came to his own, but his own rejected him and embraced the enemy. Same thing happened to the Israelites. They, instead of walking in the light, they left the light. And the moment they left out, the snakes that were in the desert, They could not come as long as the light was there. The moment they stepped out of the light of God, the snakes bit them, and within a day 23,000 people died and perished. What a sad story. The people who are led by the Lord, led by the light of the Lord, protected by the clouds of the Lord. What is the meaning of it? God can love so much. So the salvation of man doesn't depend merely on the love of God, but by the man, whether to accept that love or not. Devotee is one who is seeking God. A disciple is one who commits to be with the Master. That is a different stage. Unless we become a disciple, we cannot enjoy the holiness, the protection. My dear friends, Sangamam Plus TV is God's gift for you for our times. Like, comment, share, and subscribe. God will do wonders in your life. Praise the Lord.